Good morning students. Today we are going to study about the topic buoyancy. As we are studying about in the flotation topic, in that everything is considered with the fluids. Okay, so here we are studying about the liquids. In that, buoyancy is very important concept which I am going to explain you to. Now, buoyancy means what? You have done an experiment in a bucket. If you are putting an inverted mug and you are trying to press it down, what happens? The water also exerts an opposite force to the mug. Okay, if you are pushing more the mug downwards, the water is also pushing the mug upwards. Okay, what is there? What is that force which is pushing the mug upward? There is something. Okay, so what is that? We are going to study here. Here one example, I have drawn a diagram. Here you can see, in a vessel, and a substance is put into the vessel, which is letter A. It is denoted by letter A. And if you are trying to press the substance downward, what happens? Something is pushing it upward, a force which push the block upward. Okay, so here you can see, if you are putting something in water, some substance float in water, some substance sink in water, some substance remain in between, means it is partially immersed, or it can be partially float. Okay, so similarly, what is buoyancy? When a substance is partially or completely immersed in a liquid, an upward force, as I have explained you, something, some force which push the substance upward, okay, which is called as up thrust force. You have studied the thrust. Thrust means what? The force which acting normally or perpendicular to the surface. Okay, similarly here it is acting vertically upward. Okay, so that's why it is called as up thrust. Thrust, but it is acting upward, that is why it is called as up thrust force. Okay, so what is that which applies the force upward? It is the up thrust force. Okay, that force is called as up thrust, or it is also called as buoyant force, which push the substance upward. When you are pushing any substance downward in the water, the force which push it upward, it is called as buoyant force or up thrust force, and this property of fluid is called as buoyancy. Understood this? Okay, now I will tell you this. You know, pressure equal to force upon area. Okay, the pressure here, you can see the block, four corners I have named M, N, O, Q. Pressure, you are, if you are pushing from upward, which is denoted by pressure P1, then there is a up thrust force or buoyant force, which is called as P2. So putting these equations, we will put these two values over here. See the equation you are getting, pressure equal to force upon area. So force equal to, if this A will go that side, you will get P into area. So two pressures are there, pressure P1 and pressure P2. Okay, so what happens over here? We will find the force. If you are applying with a force, then what happens? Pressure for this P1, it is F1 equal to pressure P1 and area of this block is A. Okay, similarly for F2, F2 equal to P2A, means this P2 pressure and area of the block. Understood this? These two equations we are getting. But the condition, see here, pressure on lower surface. If you see this pressure on the lower surface, which is greater than the pressure which is applied from the upper surface. Okay? If you are pushing downwards, it again push it upwards. So, the lower surface has more pressure than the upper surface. So, the equation will become P2, which is the lower surface, is greater than P1, which is the upper surface. So as these are equal to, you can see, if the area is constant, area A is constant for the both the blocks, so that's why what happens, if the area is constant, then F1 equal to P1 and F2 equal to P2. So you can also say that force F2 will also be greater than force F1. Okay, understood? So now here same equation is carried forward. What you have to find at net force. Now net force also you have studied, net force, or it is also called as buoyant force or up thrust. What is the net force? How you are finding the net force of any substance? I have explained you, if this is a duster, now I am applying a same force from this side also and same from force from this side. So what you are doing, you are subtracting both the things. If the same force are applied from the both the side, then the net force is zero. If more force is applied from this side and less force is applied from this side, then what happens to this side? If it is less, then it will not move. Okay, so how you will find the net force over there? So net force is found by, I have explained in the class also that net force is found by the subtraction of two forces. Okay, so here also for finding net force, we are going to subtract two forces. Which force you will subtract? F2 minus F1. Okay, so buoyant force equal to F2 minus F1. So F1 you are going to, F2 you are going to put this value, F2 equal to P2A minus F1 equal to P1A. Now what happens over here? AA as the area is constant on both sides, you will take it outside. So you will take it outside. So P2 minus P1 in bracket A. So this equation you are getting for the net force for this condition. Okay. So this was the buoyancy or buoyant force I have explained. Now a small concept is there, Pascal law. Just for your understanding I am explaining here, in short I will explain you. Okay, what is Pascal's law? So what the Pascal has done, he has put for the this law, he has said in this concept that here I have drawn a small diagram, in that I will explain you. It is a field, enclosed fluid, means this fluid I have taken, but this is enclosed in a vessel. Okay, and from one side I am applying a force downward. This is enclosed in a vessel, I am pressing it from this side. You can see the water from this side, it comes up from the other side. If we are putting or pressing anything into the liquid, it comes from the other side. One more example I can tell you. If you are half filled bottle you are taking, okay, and you are pressing that bottle, what happens? The liquid comes above, upside it comes. You can see, if you press the bottle, the liquid can come upward. How it comes upward? The pressure which we are applying at this point, it gives, means what happens, it transmit to every part, transmit everywhere. And that's why, because of that pressure which is transmitted to the fluid, it makes the fluid to come upward. Understood? In bottle also same thing, if you are pressing it down the bottle, the pressure is transferred to all parts of the liquid and it makes the liquid to come above. Okay, so same Pascal law it is written here. In an enclosed fluid, if the pressure is changed in any part of the fluid, now this is constant, and suddenly what you are doing, you are applying pressure at one part of the liquid, that time what happened to the fluid, then this change of pressure is transmitted undiminishedly in the all parts of the fluid, and that's why it makes the fluid to come out of the vessel. Okay, and this practical application for this is hydraulic brakes. You know, in science experiment also you have done this experiment of hydraulic brakes, you have seen that experiment. In that what happens, in one syringe you are at one place, you are filling the liquid, and if you are pressing, if you are applying a force to that liquid, you can see the brakes are moving up and down. Means if you are applying a pressure on one surface, it makes the brakes or any instrument to move. One more is the lift system. In that also same thing it is used, because of this applied pressure, it makes the substance to move up and down. Okay, so this notes I will give you with this video, you will get and write down in your notebook. Thank you.